problem number one. At time t, a particle moving in the xy plane is at position x of t, y of t, where x of t and y of t are not explicitly given. For t is greater than or equal to 0, the derivative of x with respect to t is 4t plus 1. The derivative of y with respect to t is sine of t squared. And at time t equals 0, x of 0 is 0, and y of 0 is negative 4. Fair enough. Let's do part A. Find the speed of the particle at time t equals 3, and find the acceleration vector of the particle at time t is equal to 3 as well. So the speed is really just the magnitude of the velocity vector. So what's the velocity vector? Our velocity vector as a function of time is going to be equal to the derivative of our x position as a function of time, or we could say the velocity in the x direction times the I unit vector, plus the velocity in the y direction times the j unit vector. I just wrote this in engineering notation. Obviously, there are many ways that you could specify a vector. And in this case, x prime of t, they've already given it to us. X prime of t is 4t plus 1. They just wrote it as dx dt. So this over here is 4t plus 1 times the I unit vector. And then this here, this y prime of t, they gave it to us. The derivative of y with respect to t is sine of t squared. So plus sine of t squared plus sine of t squared times the j unit vector. That is our velocity vector. So what is our velocity, or this is our velocity vector as a function of time. So what is our velocity vector at time t equals 3? Well, we just have to substitute 3 for t. So 4 times 3 plus 1 is 13i plus 3 squared. 3 squared is 9, sine of 9, plus sine of 9j. Our speed, what they want us to figure out, is going to be equal to, or maybe I should write it as our speed at time 3. Our speed is going to be equal to the magnitude of our velocity vector at time 3, which is equal to the magnitude of 13i plus sine of 9j. And then this, we use essentially the Pythagorean theorem to find the magnitude. This is going to be equal to the square root of 169, that's 13 squared, plus sine of 9 squares. Let me get my TI-85 out. This part of the exam, we are allowed to use calculators. So we get the square root of 169 plus, the square root of 169 plus sine of 9 squared. All right, that's 13 squared plus sine of 9 squared. And we get 13.00, I'll just round it to 7, just to show that we didn't get just straight up 13, that the sine of 9 squared did do something. So 13.007. So this is approximately equal to 13.007. So we've answered the first part. The speed of the particle at time 3 equals 0 is 13.007. Then they want us to find the acceleration vector of the particle at time t equals 3. So the acceleration vector is a function of time. The acceleration vector as a function of time is just going to be the second derivative of x with respect to t, or you say the acceleration in the x direction as a function of time times I, plus the acceleration in the y direction. So it's the second derivative of y with respect to t in the j direction. And this, of course, is just going to be equal to the second derivative of x of t is just the derivative of the first derivative. So the first derivative is 4t plus 1. You take the derivative of that, you just get 4. So we get 4i plus, and then the second derivative of y with respect to t is just the derivative of the first derivative. The first derivative is sine of t squared. So derivative of that is going to be 2t times cosine of t squared. And of course, we have our j. We have our j right over there. And I just did this from the chain rule. The derivative of t squared with respect to t is 2t. Derivative of sine of t squared with respect to t squared is cosine of t squared. And so that is the acceleration vector as a function of t, but they care at time t is equal to 3. So 4 still stays 4. Then you have 2 times 3 plus cosine of 9. So let me write this. This is going to be, so our acceleration vector at time 3 is going to be 4i plus, and let's just put, if this is 2 times 3, which is 6 times cosine, 6 times cosine of 9, j. Let's get the calculator out so we actually get a value there, since they allow us to use, or almost want us to use the calculator here. So 6 times cosine of 9, 6 times cosine of 9 is negative 5.47, or 5.467 if we want. So plus negative, This is j. So plus negative 5.467 j. So that is our acceleration vector. And once again, I wrote it in engineering notation, which I'm sure the advanced placement exam people wouldn't mind. But you could also write it in kind of the parameterized vector notation or your ordered pair notation as a vector. You could say that the vector, the acceleration vector at time 3, you could write it this way too, 4, negative 5.467. These are really specifying the same thing. This is the x component of the vector. This is the y component of the vector. This is the x component of the vector. This is the y component of the vector.